am Sifu Joseph Tenam Lo. I come from a bloodline of Mongolian rulers and by direct descent hold the genetic lineage of Genghis Khan and his first wife, Empress Bort Ujin. I am Kiki no Hia Aina, or child of this land. This island of Oahu is a spiritual place because it represents the heart chakra within the Hawaiian island chain. This island has nurtured me and supported my life force. And now I am a grown man with a gift to share because of her aloha alone. So I offer my gratitude to the land. This presentation will be on the Taoist martial arts called the Longmen Sect Bagua Zhang 8 Trigram Palms. Longmen Sect is a Dragon Gate sect. Lei Gong was one of the advisors to Huang Di, or the Yellow Emperor. I work with this energy that represents righteousness and justice, hence the name Lei Gong arose from that. The Bagua is composed of 8 trigrams: lake, fire, heaven, wind, thunder, mountain, earth, and water. These trigrams correspond to the 8 extraordinary psychic channels in the human body. The 8 chakra system, 8 mudras of internal alchemy, 8 healing postures of Qigong, 8 forces of nature, 8 shamanistic powers, 8 directions, and finally the 8 palm changes of this art called Bagua Zhang. Heaven's magnetic field is Yang, and Earth's magnetic field is Yin. The human expression is a manifestation of a microcosmic universe. Uni, meaning one, and verse, meaning vibrational patterns of yin and yang, wu xing, or 5 elemental forces, and the 3 treasures, jing, qi, and shen, or body, mind, and spirit. Bagua Zhang, internal kung fu, is a cultivation way of Tao. The purpose of practicing this art is to attain health realization by regulation of the breath and elemental energies within. This produces homeostasis. In India, the Jing, or sexual vitality, is conserved in order to raise the Kundalini energy. This Kundalini energy to us as Bagua Zhang practitioners is simply called Qi. The Qi develops with both chastity and Bagua Zhang Qigong and Bagua Zhang Kung Fu. When Qi grows in the body, many psychic abilities develop and can be used for good or evil. When good is done, one's body is augmented with powerful clear white light energies. When evil is done, this clear white light energies diminishes and is replaced with turbid, blackish energies that circulate in the subtle channels of the human body. Depending upon how much of this clear or turbid energy substance one has, dictates what types of energetic forms are attracted to one's aura. The more clear white light substances one has within the body, the more fortunate one becomes. Gradually, through purification by way of eliminating evil within our habitual tendencies and replacing it with positive habits, we will develop spiritual understanding. We gradually surpass many levels of the Wu Qi, or void, and attain the Tao. This is why students of this cultivation system practice virtues such as humility, patience, kindness, love, compassion, and generosity. This is so we can fill our bodies with clear white light energy substance. This way, progress through life and beyond will be fortunate.
Hi, I'm Archie Hamai, and I am the coordinator of the programs at the Bodhi Tree Dharma Center. So, for about a year and a half, Joe Lo has come to the Bodhi tree and has taught Bagua and Qigong to the people here. I was very impressed by the fact that he came consistently and he really gave 100% to the people who were here. He was always interested in their individual problems and how he could help them. So, you know, at the Bodhi tree, what we're interested in is people's spiritual, emotional, and mental balance. A lot of times in this world, everything's so stressed out that people, you know, easily become unbalanced. And, you know, Joe's class played a big part in helping people recognize, you know, where the tight spots, where the tensions, where the inflexibility was in their bodies, and help them to, you know, work through them through his exercise. The exercise program was excellent. It went on for like an hour, just consistent movement, movement, movement. And it really made the body feel good. It also made you more aware of what was going on in the body. And actually, if you want to get into meditation, something like that, the real exercise, movement, and relaxation of the body is like the first step. And so Joe really went, he did a lot to help the people in the class, you know, attain that awareness of the body.
Hello, my name is Devani Zumigawa, and I am one of Sifu Lo's students. I've been learning Bagua Zhang from him, and a little bit of ninjutsu, which he kind of helped me, provided me with information as I was doing a project, and he provided me some vital key points as well as movements that I can use. And I first met Sifu Lo at a meeting with a psychic, and my superior at the time was telling me that I should take his class. So I started going to his classes and I've stuck with him ever since. And I've really been fortunate. He pays a lot of attention to detail with me and he really focuses on my technique and how to improve a lot of the time. Thank you.
This is a little bit about the actual application of the martial arts called Baotuajang. So we start at the point below the umbilicus, inch and a half below the umbilicus. This is our dantian. It's called qihai in acupuncture. It's an acupuncture point. We focus our qi here on this one point called the dantian, and we walk a circle. We walk a circle to stimulate the magnetic field of the earth, as well as gather energy from the sky and the environment. In a martial arts sense, when attack is coming at me in a straight line, in order to counter it from our perspective, we need to go around it. So basically, we start square, and then we go into a triangular shape, and then eventually into a circle. So here is the square aspect of Baotuajang. See, I'm squared off with him. Okay, you punch with this hand. Okay, I'm still square. Now, the triangle aspect of the Baotuajang would be cutting at him through a 45 degree angle. Like this. Then his upper jaw, upper part of the body is exposed. His posterior body is exposed, midsection, and lower aspect of his body is exposed to attack. And this is why we walk a circle, because a square is not complete. From here, if I were to strike him, he could easily defend himself with this hand or kick me and hurt me. I don't want to get hurt. That's the way I do the martial arts. Now if we start again, if I go this way, I can strike him, but only limited. This might not be enough to completely subdue my attacker. What I want to do is walk a circle. That's what Bagua's about. This way. If I hit him this way in a circle, I can complete the attack, take him out. So in terms of the single palm change, a basic application would be this. This way. And it attacks this way. And then he's on the ground, I can pin him down and strike by the point. Gallbladder 12, Sandel 17. So in essence, it's called Dinma. We are striking vital points to subdue our oppressor. Application in terms of just grappling. This way. Then I can come around into the heaven palm change. Pop the neck or crush the collarbone. This way. Where kidney 26, 27 is. Right around this area. Okay. First aspect with the square when I'm wrapping the post. That's that rear. Then we can go behind him, switch hands around. I can break his arm here just by expanding my belly button with Qigong breathing. And I can pop his neck by simply turning the waist at the dantian. And then if I just shift over this way and drill downward, he collapses his stance. Sifu Lo here. I'm going to discuss a very ancient practice which has its roots in many ancient cultures throughout time. From this root practice, this ancient practice that I will share with you today, many popular systems of meditation arose from it. And it is the most stable meditation practice that is in existence because it aligns perfectly with our human body. So we begin the meditation with calm abiding.
positions of the hands. When the hands are facing the sky, you're absorbing energy. When the hands are facing the earth, you're grounding energy. When the hands are facing each other, you're circulating and building energy. In the center of the palm is your spirit. The pinky, heaven. The earth, the thumb is earth. The pointer is body. Middle finger is mind. Ring finger is spirit. So if you were to leave the hands up, facing the sky, and touch the thumb and the index finger together, you're in a sense absorbing energy directly into your body. Likewise, if you were to touch your middle finger to your thumb, you're absorbing energy into your mind. And the ring finger and the thumb together is your spirit, augmenting your spirit with universal or cosmic energy. 3 feet below your physical feet is a chakra that resembles a red sun. So before we can access that, we need to calm our bodies down. We calm our bodies down by simply telling it to relax. It's called shamatha, or calm abiding meditation. You spend a few minutes and just relaxing your whole body, regulating the breath, making it even, sinking it down to the lower abdomen, attaining a state of deep relaxation. From this state of relaxation, you see below your feet, in your mind's eye, a red sun. The earth's magnetic field is feminine. Feminine energy is red. And this energy of the earth rises. The energy of the sky of heaven is white. The energy of heaven descends. Earth energy rises. Heaven's energy descends. Where does it rise to? It enters through your feet to the bubbling spring points, kidney one, and it accesses the root chakra. That is the beginning point of all systems. The energy then rises to the second chakra, which is water element. Then to the solar plexus, which is the will or the fire element in the body. And then to the heart chakra, where the thymus is, the throat chakra. The throat chakra has two, one at the lower border of C7, and right in front of the throat. And the third eye is located between the eyebrows and the crown at the top of your head. So this earth energy rises. So let it rise up the body through the feet, accessing the spinal cord. When you inhale, breathe in the red sun. The red sun is below your feet, 3 feet below your physical feet. It rises up, and this energy feeds the root chakra, then feeds the second chakra, and it rises up the nervous system into a rainbow. And all the while, it's spinning clockwise, as Earth's magnetic field spins clockwise in our perspective. So your entire chakra system is spinning clockwise. As you breathe in, you absorb the Earth energy. It goes up your spinal cord and ignites a rainbow, all the while spinning clockwise. When it reaches the crown, it opens. You see it opening. Because when you see it happening, you bring it into manifestation. So when you see your chakras, you see them as perfect, however you like. If you're religious, you would see gods in your chakras. If you're not religious, you can see something else of your choice. You're free to see what you like in your own nervous system. When it reaches the crown, you'll feel bliss. And when the crown chakra opens, the Hawaiians say one arm length above your head is where Akua is. From that point, you can access heaven. In Bagua Zhang, the heaven palm change, we rise the hands up and rotate around the middle finger and then come down. Because we're accessing heaven energy and bringing it to earth. Because heaven energy, like I said, descends. So this energy that descends, we want it to enter into the top of the head. The Chinese call it Bai Hui, the crown chakra. It enters into the crown chakra and descends while spinning counterclockwise. When it spins counterclockwise, it dematerializes your cellular structure. It makes it into, it causes it to vibrate at a higher rate. And you're in a sense purifying your chakra system with the white light. So above your head, you see a white moon shining brilliant white light down your crown chakra into your third eye, throat chakra, heart chakra, solar plexus, second chakra, into the first chakra and down the feet and grounding into the earth. When it mixes with the earth energy, guardian chi rises. This guardian chi can be interpreted as anything you like. Angels, ancestors, they are your own creation with the merging of heaven and earth. Ideally, from this point of the descent of the white light, you withdraw the consciousness inward. The five senses withdraw inward. And then you focus between the eyebrows and slightly down into your heart. You simply let go of concepts. And you rest in a state of freedom. This state is not really a state. It's who you are beyond the ego self. So it is the true nature of your mind, or you can call it what you like, God if you want. Such statements are not useful at this point because you see it for yourself. You see it as it is without an ego identifying with it. From this point, signs of progression would be that you feel great compassion arises spontaneously for all sentient beings. Because in this state, you understand that through nature and heaven, all beings are one. Yet not everyone is in the state of perfection that you have attained. And there is no higher goal than that. And so the martial arts, we train the jing, the body, to generate qi, the mind, to access the spirit, shen. And then we clear the mind. This is when we get insight. 81 levels of the void need to be traversed. 81 levels of this emptiness. And then the Tao can be realized for what it is. And my hope by sharing this is that everyone can experience this and bring it to earth into their everyday interactions without having a facade. You don't need to be a holy person as a title or a monk or a nun or a priest. You can be as you are. You can be who you are. You can have any personality because those things are illusory. When you realize your nature, you can play with it. You can just simply put this Maya or illusion of what is without losing sight of who you are through this rainbow body meditation. The ninja uses this meditation and calls it Kuji-in, Kuji-kiri. So the energies that rise up is the mudras that they practice, simply the chakra system. In India, they have something called Kriya Yoga, which is basically the same thing. So it is a universal practice, but instead of promoting Kuji or promoting a religion or a culture, I give it as a universal practice that has no label, simply rainbow body. And with that, I hope that it'll benefit you and benefit all of you.